Okay, so let's get right to it. I found this PNG of a Riddell SpeedFlex helmet online. I've dragged it into Photoshop, and it's roughly about 900 by 700 pixels. And I'm going to start off by cutting the gray helmet from the face mask using the pen tool. Once the helmet is selected with the pen tool, I'm going to now right click, make selection, keep the feather radius at 0, and then using the keyboard shortcut for Mac, Command J, duplicate that to a new layer. Next, I'll be removing the vent holes and stickers from the helmet because we don't want to color those once we add the color. Once that's completed, I'm going to, still using the pen tool, right click, make selection, keep the feather radius at 0, and delete that from this new layer. Now we need to make the helmet white, and to do this, we're going to duplicate this layer, change the blending mode to screen, and then duplicate that two more times. Once that's completed, you select all those layers and merge them into one, and then you'll have your white and your original gray helmet. Let's group the white helmet layer now and apply a layer mask. So hit Command G for grouping the layer, and now we're going to hold Command and click the white helmet thumbnail. That will give us a selection, and down below we're going to click on the button for layer mask. So now let's add some color. We're going to make a new layer right above the white helmet layer. And we're going to add a color red. And right now it's flat, so we have to add a blending mode of color to that. The red color is washed out and not much of the shadows are coming through. So we're going to add an adjustment layer using brightness and contrast. We're going to set the brightness to negative 100. The shadows still aren't quite there, so what we're going to do is duplicate the original layer, move it to the top, and then we're going to group it. We're going to add a curves adjustment layer. We're just going to give it a slight S curve. Then we're going to merge those two layers together with the keyboard shortcut Command E. Now let's change this blending mode to soft light and bring down its opacity to 80%. Now we can add the logo. I've decided to use my Denver Miners logo, one I've done a while back, because I think it has a nice look to it. So the colors are going to be changing here. So I'm going to my Illustrator file and I copy to Photoshop, pasting as a smart object, and then sizing and placing from there. Once the logo is placed in a good spot, I'm going to convert to a smart object and start changing the blending mode to soft light. Duplicate that twice, and the top copy, I'm going to change that to color. And this gives you a real nice logo effect, making it look like it's been placed on the helmet. So group all three of those layers and copy the helmet layer mask to it. Now I need to get the yellow color from the logo to apply to the helmet. So I double click on one of the smart object logo layers use the eyedropper tool to get that yellow and apply it to the helmet color layer. As you can see, the color tone of the logo has gotten darker. So what we're going to do is hold Command and click the logo layer thumbnail. Invert the selection with Shift Command I. Select the color layer and apply layer mask. To make the logo look more realistic, we're going to add a very faint drop shadow to it. So click on your top logo layer, add a drop shadow layer style, and your angle is going to turn to 90 because the light is coming from above. Distance 1, size 1, we're going to drop the opacity down to 20%. And that's it. You now have a fully layered football helmet that you can use with any logo, with any color that you would like. And you can definitely change the background to fit your needs. Thanks for watching and enjoy.